I'm just going to show you very quickly how to clean a garfish. I'm right-handed, so the knife is in my right hand. Garfish flesh is very tender, so if you go in too sharp at that angle, you'll damage the flesh and cut into it, which won't make it look as nice when you cook it. So you just gently, like I said before, you can get rid of a lot of these scales off the fish when you first catch it by shaking it through a bucket of water. And if you tip that bucket of water back into the sea, into the ocean, after you've caught half a dozen or so, it acts as terrific ground bait and burley because all the gunk is in there amongst it. So there you are, he's clean. How long did that take me? Took all the scales off his tummy as well. Like I said, I've only caught a dozen. Some of you will say, yeah, because you're not a very good fisherman, Greg. And that's probably partly true. But the fact is, I only need to catch 12, and I've got to feed for two or three meals. Give him a bit of a rinse. So I start with the fish on its left side down, so the back of the fish, the backbone of the fish, is facing me, and I'll show that in a minute as to why. So there's the fish. He's a nice size. He's not a huge fish, but he's certainly plenty of nice size. Put your sharp bladed knife under the edge of the gill fin. Cut down. You can hear it going through the bones. Don't let that worry you. Hold this firm. Hold this firm. Always count your fingers, five and five or whatever it is, and then slowly, not just working the pressure of your knife on. To me, what works is the bit on the backbone to get a good size fillet. So just let the front of the knife, the top of the knife, if you know what I mean, follow this bit. I know that sounds a bit double dutch, but I'm sure if you practice it, you'll get what I mean. And so you just cut along here, right to his tail, and there you've got what I would consider a reasonable fillet of garfish. There's still a few bones in there like that, but you can see that I've gone right through to the stomach casing, and there's his backbone there. Turn him over, put him up against something you can rely on that'll keep him still. Cut down through it again. You'll be really, you know, less is more, if you know what I mean. Keep cutting through those bones. Just take your time with it. This one's a little harder because he's wet, but there we go. And voila, as the French say. So if you look at that, compared to what it was a few seconds ago, that's a reasonable, I guess, by my standards, way of filleting a gar. Don't ever throw these out. They're great for crab bait, great for snapper bait, a whole range of things. You could even make a fish stock out of it. But as you notice, I've left the stomach intact so you don't get all the gizzards and the guts with it. What you've got, though, is two fillets that are still got bones and stomach lining on them. Unlike whiting and other fish, the gar, because it's what they eat, have a black stomach lining. So the big trick here, and remember you've got a left fillet and a right fillet, is to fillet those out. So what I do is, my hands are a bit dry, so I've got a bit of a damp rag to keep them dry. I very carefully place the sharp part of the knife against the edge of that. Sharp part of the knife is placed there, and I cut very ever so gently, and almost scallop out the bone. Takes a bit of practice, and I've been doing this for a few years, but believe me, it's worth it. Look at that, out it comes. Bit finicky, bit of time, but have a look at that. That's as good as you'll get in any fishmonger. I don't butterfly fillet the money because I'm not good enough at doing it. I'd lose more fish than I'd fillet, but I get away with this. And there you have it. And you just very carefully scallop that little bit out. Can you see the bones here on top of the knife blade? Look at that. Gone. Takes a bit of practice, and I'm not that good at it, but I tend to enjoy the fish much more this way. There's another one. I'll just do that one. Got to be a little bit careful if your knife is really sharp. And then on the end, you've got what the side of use the language, which what it is an anal fin. They can be a bit tough when you swallow them, so I tend to take that off. Give it a rinse in my salt water. And there you have them. Two beautiful fillets of garfish. There won't be a bone in them. Cook them lightly, cook them hot, nice glass of white wine. Bon appetit.